waters, to see the animals and waters. Now we come to last part of it. Now I'm coming to this one, Dibru Sagar. I've already mentioned that as a biosphere reserve, Dibru River. Part of the Brahmaputra is a tributary. Dibrugarh is a place in Assam. Then you have Dibru Sagar. This is what Dibru and Sagar River you will find there. And there is a flood river, Dibang, and you see that Dibrugarh and Tinsukia. And it is a very small one. There is a sanctuary also, 340 square kilometer. Sanctuary located south bank of Brahmaputra. Right, and you have journals. These are birds named Dibru. Is it clear what I have mentioned here? Now we will go to one aspect, then I will take a break here. This one part which I have mentioned here, it is just to have you. So what you need to know here from UPSC point of view, all such protected areas, biosphere reserve, best way is that you take a biosphere reserve, then see which are national parks, sanctuaries, then rivers, tributaries, all this part of it. Tiger reserves, the recently notified tiger reserve. I mentioned Baksa, Rajaji, right, these are then in Tamil Nadu there is a Sapta Mangalam, then the Kalakkad, Mundan Thurai, Agastya Marai, Biosphere Reserve, and all those newly notified tiger reserves, they become important. Now I am coming to this one, Ramsar site, you have to go through all the 26 Ramsar sites. Right, where do you find this information? You have to go to the website of ramsar.org, and if you don't want to go to the website, then I have given my book here, in the environment book. In the chapter of wetlands, mangroves and coral reefs, I have already given each Ramsar site description. Right, so there you can follow this one. Chandratal and all mentioned one is it. Every year, direct or indirect, question is asked on the wetlands or Ramsar site. Again, when you read Ramsar site, which are animals, which are plants, or which type of national parks are there? Like for example, one very common, I don't think question will be asked. But many times I find that students keep on reading that only. Kibur Lamja. Question has come. Fodi and Loktak Lake, Kibur Lamja, Montrex Record. This is a known thing. You have to go to unknown areas, different areas. Right? There you can follow that. And I'll just go to such area. This I have also shared in my Facebook there. But I'm just briefly going to that. Snow Leopard. Right? Snow Leopard. Part of the snow leopard, you know that is, I have already said vulnerable. Now there are certain doubts are there, whether it is critically, sometimes when you read books or materials, you may have doubt what category. But this is the category in latest by the IUCN. It will be vulnerable. So I have already mentioned that, they are the, remember that, snow leopard are called monarch of the mountains, they are king of mountains. High mountains they are. Government of India has got project snow leopard for conservation of leopards, snow leopards. Right? Then there is a great Indian buster, GIB. Right? Tall birds which you find. And I have said they look like ostrich. Right? And this is a state bird of Rajasthan. You find this is a state bird. Now what is here? See, very important information. There are four species of busters in India. GIB, Lesser Floricular, Bengal Floricular, and Hubara Buster. Hubara Buster is a migratory. And in the world, they are among the most threatened all the 22 busters found in the world. In worldwide 22 busters are there, out of them 4 are in India. Is now locally extinct from almost 90% of the range. Right, 90% loss has happened of GIB. Right? So they are now critically endangered. Now what came in the current news? When we read about it here, Rajasthan state will have captive breeding center for GIB. So that is the current affair material as well. But you should know this fact. These are the very part. Arid, semi-arid and moist grassland system where you find this part of animal population. Now, one you find famous Hangul, Kashmiri stag, red deer. What is the name of the national park which is known for conservation of Hangul in Kashmir Valley? Kashmir Valley. What is the name of the national park? Dachigam. Dachigam National Park. It's a very old park. I remember that Dachigam, before independence, India became independent in 1947, but during the British time, at that time also, itself the park was there. Right? It's a very unique species there. Now which cattle? Critically endangered. Hangul is critically endangered. Right? It belongs to critically endangered. Is most critically endangered species found in temperate grassland of Western Himalayas. Very clearly, Western Himalayas. Not Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. Not Eastern Himalayas. It's a part of Western Himalayas. And where you find grasslands, temperate grasslands. Not tropical grasslands. They're like a deer. You see them, you've seen the photograph there. Then what comes is Dachigam. Dachigam National Park in Kashmir represents such grassland. What is very important? This temperate grassland, you find the Dachigam. Let's say you get a question, geographical question, from geography. This is what you have to look at. Right? Then comes this one, which you all know that Karnataka's materials are covered, Nilgiri Tahar. What type of habitat Nilgiri Tahar is in? I think few of you would have gone to Nilgiri, would have seen that cited this. Anyone who has cited, seen this in Nilgiri Tahar? Huh. What type of landscape? Again, grassland. What type of grassland Nilgiri and Western grassland are called? Shola. They are found in Shola grassland, which is a unique grassland. So what type of grassland? Temperate or tropical? This grassland is tropical or temperate? Huh? Western grass, you know that. This is a lot of rainfall.
Temperate
or tropical? There we, Dachigam is a temperate grassland. Red deer. What about this one? Nilgiri Tahar. Tropical. Tropical because of the tropical evergreen or semi-green. Semi-evergreen grassland. Shola forest and Shola grassland of Western Ghats, Nilgiri, is a very important habitat. Right? So, there this comes. Now, which category? Now, GK, general knowledge. Nilgiri Tahar comes which category? Critically endangered, endangered, vulnerable, where?
Endangered.
It belongs to endangered. Endangered category. Right? As per IUCN Red Data Book, endangered species. So, the mountain goat. What is very important? Not sheep but goat. Bakra. Right? Bakri. Aajkal halim chal raha hai. Iska loom with that. Iska halim bahut dangerous hoga. Nobody should do that. Right? Schedule 1. What comes here? Schedule 1 species. Right? That is where this bakra comes. Nilgiri bakra. Right? So, where the grassland is. Now, Western Ghats, flagship species there, and the habitat is the rocky outcrop present to Shola grassland and other regions there. So remaining the wild berry less than 2000. Less than 2000 individuals are there. So when you go to Nilgiri, right, Munnar, I'll give you one very important place, Munnar. Munnar is in Kerala, and there you come across this Tahar. Now worldwide there are three Tahars are there. Nilgiri Tahar, Himalayan Tahar, and Arabian Tahar. So India has got two, Himalayas, Himalayan Tahar and Nilgiri Tahar. Right? Now, this has been most of the materials have covered. Sangai, right? Manipuri, deer. Right? What is the name of this deer? There is one name is here. Huh? Sangai is the local name. In Manipur, there is a local name called Sangai. But what is the name of the deer? Hmm? Bro antler deer. It is called Bro Antler Deer. This antelope, this is like antler, horn, looks like Bro, right? They are Bro Antler Deer. So where it is found? Which is a famous national park? Of this Bro Antler Deer? Huh? Yes, Kebo Namjaw. Where Kebo Namjaw is located? Which lake is there? Loktak Lake, which is Ramsar side of India, right? And I have already said that is known for unique floating vegetation called fungis. These all have come in the exam. Popularly, this deer is also called dancing deer. They don't dance, but the way they move, they look like dancing deer. So they are found in the fungis and all. A unique type of structure floating vegetation and soil in Loptak Lake. And Loptak Lake comes in Montreux River. What is Montreux River called? Ramsar Conservation. What is Montreux River called? It is a list of threatened Ramsar sites where ecological characters have changed or changing or might change because of pollution, human interference. That's where part of the Montreux River called. India had earlier Chilka Lagoon, but Chilka was removed from the list. Now we have Loptak Lake and second is Keula Lake in Rajasthan. So Sangai Lake. Now which category is Sangai belongs? Vulnerable, endangered, critically endangered, where it belongs? I used to read that about where it belongs. Endangered. Where it belongs there? Endangered. Right? Not critically endangered. Endangered. Right? So you have to know three categories: critically endangered, endangered, vulnerable. So these blocks are endangered. So I have given here Sangai or Manipuri race of Elk's deer. Not saying what is the document says? ELDS. Elk's deer is the only deer which has adapted to swampy habitat. Fogaries are kind of a soil and vegetation. Swampy habitat. Right? And unique animal in the world. Kibu Lamjau. Kibu Lamjau, Loptak Lake, floating biomass, Fogari. They are found. And Sangai population has gone down to hunting and all this. So in fact, the deer was considered almost extinct in 1950s. Right? After independence, 1950s, it was considered to be almost extinct. But now it is a kind of endangered cattle. Right? They belong to the endangered cattle. Then vultures. The whole tell me all about vultures. Let's know about vultures information. I'll give you one important information other than the current affairs. But first, let us discuss the general thing about vultures. How many types of vultures in India? 9 types. How many types of vultures are found? 9 types of vultures. 4 have become critically endangered. Right? 9 types of vultures are there. Now, what is so unique about this bird? Vultures? Scavengers. They are natural scavengers. They feed on dead bodies. They eat the dead bodies. So what the role the vultures play? They clean the environment. Vultures clean the environment because they feed on dead bodies. It's the scavenger. That's the role of vultures. Right? Third thing, diclofenac, which I've said. Now, can you name a category of vultures which have become critically endangered? Category, there's one word is there. One very unique word is there, which is known for vultures which have become less than 95%, less than 5%. 95% population has declined. What is the name of that category of vultures? There is one particular word is there. GYPS, GYPS. You should remember this name, the GYPS vultures. Diclofenac and all the, has the, have more impact on GYPS vultures. GYPS bengalensis, GYPS indicus, white-backed vulture, long-billed vulture, slender-billed vulture, they belong to this kind of a GYPS vultures, right? So, what conservation steps have been carried by government of India, vultures in India? Or what conservation steps is there? Breeding. One is the captive breeding. So, where in India, famous captive breeding center of vulture in India? Haryana. What is the name of the place? In Haryana, the vulture breeding is there. What is the name there? Jatayu. The Jatayu breeding center, and the name of the place is Pinjor. Pinjor in Haryana is an internationally acclaimed center. Funding comes from outside India also. And Haryana Forest Department and Ministry of Environment, Forest, Climate Change. And there we do the captive breeding for vultures. It's a very famous center there. Right? Now let's see what report says about vultures there. Government reports, these are the points there. I'll just read out a small one is that 9 species of vultures are found in India and 5 belongs to GYPS. What is this the report? 9 types of vultures in India, 5 are GYPS vultures. Right? Now, three GIFs. Three GIFs vulture, oriental round vulture, GIF megalysis, long bill vulture, GIF epicus, slender bill vulture, GIF perinostris. Five are GIFs, now three of the GIFs. This you have to remember, these three names, you should remember it, you should buy heart. That out of these five, which are GIFs vulture, which are critically endangered. So long bill vulture, slender bill vulture, and white rump, or interview is white rump vulture, white back vulture. That have become, here remaining two, Eurasian griffon, vulture, GIF fulvus, and griffon, Himalayan griffon, GIF himalayensis, are largely wintering species. Now these three GIFs above are critically endangered. But what is this sentence saying? All these five GIF vultures, where you have Eurasian griffon, Himalayan griffon, right? All these are wintering migratory birds. In winter they migrate, right? Then what is given here? About this one, white back vulture and long-billed vulture were abundant in India until 1990. But then you know that because of 97% is replaced by diclofenac. What is the name of the drug here? DICLOFENAC. Anti-inflammatory drug given to cattle, disease cattle, has led to a decline because of bio-magnification. Right? This kind of information is important. Okay. Now I am giving you information which is not in current affairs. Not in current affairs. I am giving you something different. First vulture safe zone. What is the word here? VSF. First vulture safe zone declared in Bangladesh. Not in India, Bangladesh. First vulture safe zone. For protection of vultures, there's a two safe zones have been created. Now what is zero tolerance shown towards there? What is the safe zone? No diclofenac. There should not be any use of diclofenac in and around that area. India has also declared, but first two which come to Bangladesh. Now here, they are through the law, this is the Wildlife Presence Security Act 2012 of Bangladesh, not India. Right? And Dhaka and Chittagong. Sylhet is the part there. They are part of Dhaka and Chittagong. Covering an area, they have declared there. Vulture safe zone. Right? So vulture safe zones are those areas which prevent the use of diclofenac. Right? Because of the problem with diclofenac. So our neighboring country has taken this role there and has declared these two areas there. Right? So this is done with the help of which agency? There has to be some kind of body, organization, which declares that. Who will tell which body the name of organization comes? Vulture safe zone. See, breeding centers and all, that is the government of India. Central government gives the fund and set up those breeding centers. But this initiative, VSZ, comes from which organization? IUCN. Where it comes from? International Union for Conservation of Nature. Right? VSF concept is from IUCN. Right? International Union for Conservation of Nature. That gives the fund and helps in setting up the VSZ with the help of the government of the country. Right? So that's what you have. But you should know the objective. Why it is declared? Diclofenac, the role of diclofenac is possible. This is Bangladesh map and this part you find Sylhet. This is Sylhet and part of it. And then you have this one, which goes to Chittagong and all this, which is nearer to the Sundarbans. Sundarbans is later. You know, Sundarbans is part of India also and Bangladesh. Right? So Sundarbans already has made the news. Last class also sir would have said about that West Bengal part of Sundarbans to be added to Ramsar list. And the proposal is there. Already Sundarbans Delta is a Ramsar site of Bangladesh. Already they have. And you have learned yesterday about what will happen with Bangladesh in climate change impact. Right? There will be sea level, rising sea level. And density, you know that most densely populated country in this region, South Asia, that is Bangladesh. Right? Now this Malabar Sea, where do you find Malabar Sea? Kerala and Karnataka. Which category? It's a nocturnal animal, it's not found in daytime. In Mysore, when you go to Mysore, Mysore Zoo, a very big zoo is there, Chiriagar. And there you find dark room. And the dark room, there is a cement district. It was once thought to become extinct, but not as critically endangered. It comes into category of critically endangered. It was once thought to be lost, but not as critically endangered. So, this is what you find in nocturnal bird. Malabar, Travancore, southwest, and low elevation, moist forest of Western Ghats. Like low, there's extensive deforestation has led to the decline in the number. Habitat loss. One horned rhino, I have already mentioned it. This is one horned rhino. We have learned that. Which category comes? Vulnerable. We have learned about rhino there. Now, static lion. Last time there was a question. Like transportation of lion from Gir forest, Gujarat, to Kunu, Palpur in Madhya Pradesh. So which category acetic lion comes? Endangered. Right? Not critically endangered, endangered. Even not vulnerable. As per present IUCN list, acetic lion is endangered. What type of forest they look lions? Lions to deciduous forest. And again grassland. You find deciduous, grassland and forest. They will not find an evergreen forest or they are deciduous. So, Gir forest wildlife, and there we have a project for that. Now, recently it came in the news that our population has increased. And I'll give you a few names there. Bhavnagar, there's a Gir, Saurashtra. Then Amreli, there's a place called very important one. Let me write for this. Amreli, Junagadh. Junagadh, Amreli. Amreli is a, even we go to Amreli, Junagadh, sometimes in those village areas, lions just pass by. Not, see, very people are afraid if the lion comes and what will happen. But if lion and any animal will not attack you, if you are there, right, unless until they have become man-eater, then there is a risk. Right? Because sometimes leopard or tiger, they become man-eater, then there is a risk out there. But generally they pass by. And there the villagers say that the lions have been in and out. And you have a house there, there is just 10 meter, 15 meter lion is there. Lion is a very lazy kind of animal. Like they just take a rest and sleep there. Amreli, Amreli, Gujarat. You find this good population there. Then Gir forest, Bhavnagar. Actually, Junagadh, Amreli, and Bhavnagar. 9,000 square kilometers. It's called Gir range, that comes in Gujarat range. Swamp deer is a state animal of UP. Which category of swamp deer will be there? But swamp deer is in Sundarbans, Kaziranga, Manas, all the places. Which category belongs? Their numbers are more vulnerable. They belong to vulnerable category. Right? Vulnerable category. Now, one important turtle, leatherback turtle, marine turtle, heaviest turtle of the world, heaviest. They go to 900 kilograms. Pacific Ocean, Atlantic, Indian Ocean. They are abundant. Now, as per India's Indian government, it is critically endangered. Indian government has considered to be critically endangered, but IUCN Red Data Book, it is not critically endangered. IUCN Red Data Book is vulnerable because the numbers are more. Leatherback turtle, polybridley turtle, you know that, Gahir Mata, polybridley turtles, leatherback turtles, and what is called loggerhead turtles. All these three turtles are vulnerable. There is one turtle which is critically endangered as per IUCN Red Data Book, what is called here Hawksbill turtle. Hawksbill turtle is critically endangered. This is critically endangered. Others are vulnerable. Right? Then the mouth looks like hawk. And this is white-billed heron, Nam Dhapa, Arunachal Pradesh. It is a critically endangered bird. It belongs to critically endangered bird, white-billed heron. And there is a, where you find this, Myanmar, Bangladesh, Bhutan, and this part. They found cloud forest gladiators, Bhutan and all these places. In Bhutan, they migrate, this migratory bird. Right? It is a migratory bird and found in this India, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Myanmar. A critically endangered bird of India and worldwide. And this is what you find there. This bird, Narkondam hornbill. Where is Narkondam? Andaman and Nicobar. Which category? Endangered. Where it belongs is endangered. 40-50 centimeter, small, distinctive, dark hornbill with pale blue, bluer pouch and all white tail. And this is what you find there. And they make a very interesting sound. This cackling sound is there. And they're top birds. You find in Chiliagar, zoo they are kept there. Right? They can fly also there. Now, endemic to Andaman Nicobar, there is an island called Narkondam Island, there it is found. It has not been sighted for a long time. There was a report there, that's what I put up there. Then there was an eagle, very unique eagle, Great Nicobar Serpent Eagle. They eat the snakes and all this, the birds of prey. So, Great Nicobar is a biosphere reserve of India, and Great Nicobar is also into World Network of Biosphere Reserve. Leatherback turtles, you will find nesting in Great Nicobar, southernmost island of Nicobar. Right, there you find this, and this is a near threatened. This eagle is near threatened. Right, not critically endangered, not vulnerable, not this is near threatened. You will find near threatened. Now, last thing about 2017 red dog, Irrawaddy dog. Yesterday also you have covered that. Which category is now this dog? New red dog home. It's found which place in India? Chilika. Chilika Lagoon has Irrawaddy dog. Right. Which category belongs now? Endangered. It has moved from vulnerable to endangered. It's endangered. And one of the threat is gillnet. Gillnet overfishing, then hunting and poaching that comes in. As per new IUCN data book, this many of the current affairs material has been